developmental truncated pyramid, or prism. So in this example, we have our pentagon going up to meet at our point. So all these sides are slanted, however, this one side is actually a rectangle. But to show you how you find true length, I'm going to draw a circle to one of the tips. So as you can see, when it goes to the end, all of them meet at the same point. So basically, this line here from the center to this point, this line is the true length of the slanted sides. So we need to carry this up to the end up here. So this line would be the true length, so you could see the difference there. So this, although you've seen it, it goes up to this point, the true length is a little on the outside. So each of these 150 divided by 5 is 30, so each side is 30. So let's copy the true length side, because as we want to be using, draw a circle with radius 30. That is one side of the prism, the base, and you draw another circle with here, so this would be one side here. Copy. So you wanna create 5 triangles like this because you wanna keep doing it. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So then the line, so the 5 triangles will create the 5 sides of the development. So you can delete your construction afterwards. Right, and then you just have the truncated side. You can just carry the line straight across. So, because it's a straight truncation, you're just drawing a circle from the peak to meet at that point. So the actual area in between here is the actual development. Okay, so this is your development surface.